It's time for a quick recap of ISMB ECCB 2025 in Liverpool. I'll cover the current trends and the latest surprises in bioinformatics. What should come as no surprise to anyone is that there was artificial intelligence absolutely everywhere, to the point that it was almost too much. It all started with AlphaFold being presented in the opening keynote by John Jumper and subsequently used for anything involving protein structures. A highlight for me was the talk about benchmarks and baselines, a keynote given by Charlotte Dean. She explained how, when using proper, well-designed benchmarks, it often turns out that fancy AI methods perform not much better than way simpler baseline methods. There was plenty of work on autoencoders and transformers, applying them to network embeddings, as well as to embedding of omics data. This is especially true for single-cell transcriptomics, which was the topic of Fabian Theis's closing keynote. There's still a lot of work being done on large language models, of course using them for every aspect of literature mining, as well as for generating structured metadata for example, microbiome data, and for ontology curation, as explained by Chris Mungle. Agent-based systems was another big focus. There were many talks and posters about how to automate workflows and even supposedly the entire research process. However, I have to say that this is an area that is prone to exaggerated claims and often involves agents with so strong prompting that it's basically agents with no agency left. The big surprise to me was quantum computing. There were surprisingly many talks as well as posters on the topic, and IBM had a very strong presence. They were presenting several network-related applications, but I have to say that when it comes to quantum computing, it is very much a solution looking for a problem. And that's the summary of ISMB ECCB this year. I hope to see many of you at ECCB next year.